first of all, appreciate the compeer in his pre-event remarks, speaking so glowingly of what we have done in FRA, especially of late. So on behalf of my colleagues, we want to also appreciate you. Thank you so much. And also to, before going to the address of the executive chairman proper, to apologize on his behalf for not being here personally. Would have loved to. As a matter of fact, he gave his word, realizing that he will be in Lagos for, I mean, at this time. Unfortunately, he probably didn't record with the very crazy traffic situation in Lagos. And some people advised him not to try it. There's a board missing of the service going on at the Highland, and he thought he could just dash down and go back. He realized that at the end of the day, it may not be effective on both sides at all. And since some of his very senior people are here, he has mandated us to deliver this address. Sorry, please. His Excellency, the Deputy Governor of Lagos State, Dr. Femi, the Governor of Akwa Ibom, who was also UP represented and has spoken to us virtually, the Senior Special Assistant to the President of Digital Transformation, Oswald Saritin Gobadaya, the convener himself, that is the Executive Chair of DigiSAV Network Service, Engineer Lani Ajayi, other distinguished members of the top table, members of the press, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. It's my pleasure and privilege to welcome you all to this unique gathering which brings together stakeholders and key representatives from all sectors of the Nigerian economy. And the purpose of the summit is to enable us to interact with ICT, which ordinarily is information and communications technology, but I have chosen to christen innovation, convenience, and transparency, services provided by key government agencies. The advent of the COVID-19 pandemic profoundly brought to the fore the significance of technology. And as a result of that, many people without much advocacy migrated significant business deals online. As such, commerce literally moved online, with many more people buying and selling via the internet. It is common for students to take tuition online. Even patients are able to consult doctors online. This year's summit is focused on the policies, the strategies, the solutions, and technologies required to achieve accelerated e-government deployment at the federal, state, and local government level. It is therefore noteworthy that the organizers of this event have deemed it necessary to assemble world-class experts and solution providers to share their experience and showcase latest innovations. The top government officials invited to this summit will not only learn from the experts, but also share their experience and showcase the state of e-government services deployment in their respective domains. Distinguished participants, discussions at this summit will suggest ways to develop our great country as well as to create the enabling environment to nurture businesses and investments. This summit must offer ways of enhancing ease of doing business via e-government initiatives, that is, automation of government processes. As a nation, we must acknowledge the critical roles that ICT plays in our day-to-day personal, social, and business lives. It is heartwarming that some government sectors, including finance, health, education, and agri have started to employ technology for effective and efficient information dissemination and service delivery generally. As such, it is clear that an enabling ICT environment is required in order to promote investment in those sectors. Nigeria desires to be ranked among top 10 in terms of most improved companies in the world based on World Bank ranking. This is a big statement and is an indication that Nigeria is making the right run. Everyone, including government, understands that ICT is a catalyst developing entrepreneurship, particularly among the youth. We can surely use ICT to transform Nigeria into a competitive business model. The duty is imposed on all of us to develop and implement a framework that will stimulate, promote, and encourage innovation and promote efficient service delivery. Distinguished guests, the theme of this year's e-government summit points us to the opportunities inherent in the use of ICT, particularly how ICT can be used to improve our daily living and promote economic growth through small and medium enterprises. Many developing countries, SMEs are contributing significantly to economic growth. The move towards a better Nigeria can be easily realized by creating an environment that promotes SMEs. Therefore, it is important to provide the kind of opportunities available to SMEs operating in the urban areas to those operating in rural areas. We must seek to provide affordable ICT infrastructure to everyone, including the shea butter farmer, the community health nurse, a startup looking for capital to set up a business, the woman buying drugs who wants to check the authenticity of the drug, or the student who simply wants to order a book online. And as been said earlier, a lot around all these have been done at FIRS in order to make life much convenient for our customers and to encourage voluntary compliance. The growing Nigerian online market, particularly mobile apps, is already opening up opportunities for various service providers to offer their services and products to a greater number of potential customers. In some cases, we are seeing increased customer satisfaction and new employment opportunities being generated. SMEs across the country should take advantage of various e-government initiatives to drive growth. Doing so has the potential of boosting businesses for SMEs, also creating new tax revenue base for government. It's in the interest of all that the tax revenue base grows, especially given the fact that funding of government budgets rests more these days on tax authorities, particularly the Federal Inland Revenue Service. Let me assure all that we are up to the task of making our nation great again. Thank you. It is, however, important that we all work together to build the Nigeria of our dream. The government, working with all stakeholders, is providing appropriate environment for adoption of ICT. This will increase competitiveness among SMEs and create flexible lanes to trading partners for faster and more reliable channels. In this light, I wish to urge all to conduct an open and honest discussion of facts and issues so that we are able to arrive at what is best for our country. Ladies and gentlemen, please permit me to use this opportunity to express my sincere thanks to the organizers, and in particular, Engineer Larry Ajayi. All our honorable speakers of today, the media, and participants who have taken time out of their busy schedules to be here today. I thank you all for listening. Thank you.